This is Amazon Sellers Breaking News for Wednesday, September 18th, 2019, and the top five stories in 5 quick minutes. Good news, yesterday was another day with no listing violation suspensions based upon pricing. Also, we had zero restricted product suspensions yesterday, so these things are great. These are on the decline. 72-hour notices with intellectual property right complaints are up. We're going to get into the details in a few moments. Suspensions for high ODR rates continue to climb. Vorys is back. There must have been a whole lot of Vorys letters sent because we received multiple calls about Vorys letters. We're going to talk about that. And Victoria's Secret. It seems like Victoria's Secret might have a new deal with Amazon. First breaking news story, good news for Amazon sellers. Yesterday was the second or third day in a row where we stopped getting calls about listing violation suspensions based upon your pricing. Amazon has not accused sellers, as far as we are aware, of price gouging or improperly accused sellers of price gouging. We have not received one of those calls, emails, or chats. And now I think it's up to 3 days. That's really good news for sellers. Also, the number of calls, chats, and emails that we have received regarding restricted product suspensions has absolutely gone down. And to me, this means that you are getting suspended a whole lot less for this particular issue. Breaking story number two is that we're continuing to see an increase in 72-hour notices where sellers have received intellectual property right complaints. There's been no evaluation, as far as we are aware, whether those complaints are valid or 100% baseless. We are seeing an increase in the number of sellers where Amazon is actually making phone calls to you, and you gotta be prepared for those calls. Now, I spoke to sellers who are outside the United States today. We had multiple sellers yesterday. 72-hour notices means you have to try and get retractions right away. Do a legal analysis to show that you're not violating anybody's intellectual property rights. Get a plan of action out the door that refers to the legal opinion letter and also shows your attempt to get those IP complaints retracted. If you want to talk to us about helping you with the IP complaints, if you are anticipating a call from Amazon, contact us. We are here to help sellers. Third breaking news story, high ODR rate suspensions continue to climb. Watch your rates. If you need to pull back on certain listings, if you need to change your shipping mechanism, if you need to change your packaging, you need to do it before your ODR rate goes up. You do not want a high ODR rate suspension. If you get one, you need a really concise, persuasive plan of action with a tremendous focus on the long-term changes to your business that will assure the staff at Amazon that your ODR rate will go back down to acceptable levels. Okay, fourth breaking news story. There's a law firm called Vorys. If you've been selling for any period of time, if you're a third-party seller selling other brands, you may have received a letter from the Vorys law firm, V-O-R-Y-S, and we have seen another wave of their letters going out the door. Now, the good news is that a significant portion of the claims that Vorys asserts against sellers are 100% baseless. Some of the claims have merit, and I can't tell you whether yours is baseless. Some of the claims have merit or a combination of the two without actually seeing the letter, so call and send us those letters for a consultation. But they're sending out more and more letters. Also good news for sellers that despite how threatening those Vorys letters are, we have seen Vorys start very, very few lawsuits. Fifth breaking news story, Victoria's Secret. Now, we don't know whether Victoria's Secret has made a deal with Amazon where Amazon's gonna protect Victoria's Secret products, but we are seeing an increase in the number of phone calls, chats through our website, and emails being sent to us where Amazon is sending intellectual property right issues to sellers without an email from Victoria's Secret. Okay, so if you are selling Victoria's Secret products, you may want to think twice. If it's not a huge moneymaker for you, maybe you want to avoid it. And I certainly, unless there's an absolute ton of money to be made, it's not a brand I would get into right now. The name of the game in business is avoiding problems and making money. And Victoria's Secret seems to be the source of problems for sellers all over the United States. And if you want to learn more about inauthentics, intellectual property right complaints, rights owner complaints, the new terms of service, how to win ODR cases, how to get your listings back, how to write plans of action, please visit our YouTube channel, Rosenbaum Familaro. Rosenbaum Familaro, the law firm behind AmazonSellersLawyer.com. And please join me again tomorrow morning for another episode of Amazon Sellers News.